Yo, what's up? This is your girl Dragon, and it's time for another Fortnite creative tutorial. In this quick tip, I'm going to show you two ways to use the channel device, and we're going to dive into some really cool ones. For instance, I'm going to show you how to send and listen to global events using the channel device, as well as how to detect if a player is building. All right, it's going to be super quick, super easy, and if you guys enjoy tutorials like this, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss a thing. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and jump into this one. Let's go. Yo, welcome. Let me go ahead and show you guys what we're building today. We're going to be looking into two different ways you can use the channel device. This is something that I wanted to explore since seeing that you can call events based upon the global name of the device, and the device can also listen for that global name and send an event. So let me go ahead and first show you the first setup, and then I'll show you the settings for that. And then I'll show you the second setup on what you can do with the channel device. All right, let's get into it. All right, this first setup allows you to send an event upon a global name being listened to once a target is reached. So I have two bots patrolling an area here, and I need to get past this zone. In addition to that, every zone I get past, I'm gonna get a supply drop, which really helps me when moving forward to the next zone. So as you can see here, I have a tracker, and once I eliminate all targets within this zone, a global event is called, as you can see there, and my supply drop is falling. Really cool. All right, so if you're interested in this setup, let me go ahead and show you the settings. Let's do it. All right, so you're going to need two channel devices and a tracker if you're tracking eliminations or events. If you're going to be using the exact same setup with a supply drop, be sure to drop one of those as well. And I have guards here to protect the zone. Let's first start with the channel bots eliminated, and that's what I named this first channel device. This is the device that's going to broadcast the first event, the main event. Broadcast global event name is bots eliminated. And keep in mind, the name is case insensitive, so be sure to accommodate that. For functions, we're going to transmit and receiving from tracker bot when complete, and there are no events. For my tracker, I have it set to events and a target value of 2 and so forth. And for functions, we're going to increment the progress when receiving from the guard spawner when eliminated. For events, when complete, we're going to send an event to the guard spawner to despawn, and the channel bots eliminated to transmit. For the second channel device, we're going to name that channel listen bots eliminated. And that is because this channel device is only going to be listening for that global event. As you can see, the name is exactly the same as my global event name for my main channel device. There are no functions, and on events, on receive transmit, we're going to send an event to the supply drop spawner to drop the supply. Next, we have the supply drop spawner, and these are the options that I have for this device. Again, you can do this however which way you like, and be sure to have fun with it. For functions, we're going to go ahead and spawn the supply drop when receiving from channel listen, bots eliminated on receive transmit. And again, that should already be binded as well. And there's no events. For the guard spawner, I have it set to ghost with a spawn count of 2 and a total spawn limit of 2. The team is set to wildlife and creatures, and they spawn within 1 second. For functions, we're going to despawn when receiving from tracker bot when complete, and that should already be binded. And for events, we're just going to see that it should already be binded, but uneliminate it, send event to tracker bot, increment progress. There you go. That's how you set this up, and it's pretty simple. Pretty cool. All right, next setup is you can use the channel device in an input trigger to detect when a player is building. Now, this is a really big one because this is something that would be so beneficial for particular game genres, specifically practice genres and so forth. It's really great and it doesn't require a lot of devices to get it started. So let me go ahead and run a test so you can see what it looks like, and then I'll show you the settings. All right, so here I am in my game area. And every time I begin to build, you're gonna see that alert goes up. And for PS5, it's when I press the O or zero button. It's going to send alert that player is building. Now, it's gonna send the alert even if they don't drop anything, right? If you wanna send it at the time they actually drop something, for PS5, you can see that's R2. You'll have to find the button in the input trigger to assign it to that button, okay? But you can see how it's sending the event every time I press the O button. See? Really cool. All right, so let me go ahead and show you the settings for this. All right, so for the channel build detector, you want to make sure that you have a broadcast global event name called Player's Building. And this is to prepare you for setting up another channel device if you want to listen and send some type of event. For functions, I have it transmit when receiving from the input trigger on input press. And when it receives a transmit, it's going to send an event to the message device to show player is building. For the input trigger, I have it set to custom 11, which is button O or 0 in PlayStation 5. It's not going to show on HUD, however you can if you want to. It's enabled at game start and so forth. There are no functions, and on input press it should already be binded, send event to channel build detector on transmit, and that's it. And for my HUD message, just to ensure that the event is being called correctly, I just have this pop up. It shows player is building, and for the events, it's going to show when receiving from channel build detector on receive transmit. And that's it. Very simple setup to show and detect when the player is building in your map. And there you go. Two different ways on how to use the channel device. If you ever consider using it this way, or even if you haven't, drop a comment below. I'll be sure to check it out. In addition, if you feel so kind, be sure to drop some support my way. My credit code's right there on the screen. And if you do, you are super awesome. All right, you guys, that's gonna do it for this video, and I will see you on the next one, okay? Bye.